happen.
Thank you. Let me get this going here first.
I don't know if they can turn that off.
Okay. That would
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Well, I should not do that to the microphone. Okay. Can you hear me back there? If I stand right here, can you hear me? Very good. Welcome to Aromas. Thank you for coming. My name is Ed Whitaker. I am with Panglossian Productions. And yes, thank you very much. We are beginning to do a series of play readings, readings of new plays by new playwrights that we are presenting to the community. In way of developing them for a more fully realized production later on. So we do these readings and we solicit feedback from the audience. We might have our playwright, and see, I don't know if he's Skyping in with us tonight, which I'll talk about in a little bit here. But anyway, welcome to this. We thank you for coming, and we want to thank Aromas very, very much for allowing us to use this spot to do it. They have a lot of support, yes. They have a lot of support of the arts, if you don't know. So they have open mic nights here for music every week. They have poetry readings. I wonder if we should shut that door.
Good luck with that. You want this one too?
Yeah, let's do that. Thanks. They also have poetry readings. There's even photography over there. A friend of mine actually has his pictures hanging on the wall for sale on the far side over there. And they have Pulse magazine here, which is an area mag about the events that are going on. So Aromas supports the arts. Thank you for letting us be here tonight. If you want more information about Panglossian, it's www.panglossian.org, and you can find information about our company on that website. We have plays that are upcoming. This season is going to be K2, Scream Queens, and Women in Black from about, somewhere around May through
June
and October, or something like that. So that's going to be, we'll have more information on the website about that. But tonight's offering is called In Search of the Amherst County Wildman. And it is about a man's 40-year search for Bigfoot. He has hired a Creature Quest reality TV show guy to document his final search for Bigfoot. And lots of interesting things ensue. So this is by Elford Alley. And Elford is, I'm just going to read a little bit of bio. Hello, Elford, are you with us? I hope you are.
Yeah.
Elford is very excited to have his play be a part of Panglossian Productions. Elford's a regular contributor to the music blog riffraff.net and has written for cracked.com. He recently attended the End Station Playwrights Initiative, and currently he lives in Texas with his wife Katie and daughter Ruby. So Elford Alley is our playwright, and thank him for letting us use his play to test on an audience here. So now, described a little bit about the play. A reading is just that. It's just really actors up here reading their parts and testing out how it's sounding. Because this particular production involves visuals as well from some screening and from video footage, I decided to go ahead and add some of that into the reading. So we're going to be hearing readings. We're also going to see some stuff on the screen, and there'll be a little bit going on the camera here, as if this was a documentary being made. So that's what you're going to be seeing tonight. And at the end of our production, for those of you who want to stick around, we were also, and Lauren, can you do this, please? Can you go ahead and... Part of this play development is that we solicit feedback from the audience. If you have, now these are some questions that you're getting here that the playwright has wished us to address. So if you have comments or offerings about that based on those questions, we'll be soliciting those from you at the end of the play. And any other comments you want to make, there's room to answer the stuff there. If you want to make comments in the back, you're welcome to do that. So questions are on there, they're pretty self-forward, but was any part of the play confusing? Were any of the characters' motivations unclear? Questions like that. It'll make sense as you hear the rest of that. All right. So, is there anything I'm leaving out?
I don't think so.
Okay. Ready.
Did you want to introduce cast first? Or
I guess I could. Yeah, I'll do that afterwards. Well, no, I won't, because some people might not be able to
see.
Yeah. Robert Weathers. Steve Holloway.
Yay!
Christina Courtright-Westenberger.
Sharon Holland, Alex Morse, Michael Westenberger, stage manager Amy Lyles, Brandon Lyles on the tech, and
you.
I think we got
Who
it.
Are
Ed
you?
Whitaker already said me.
Okay.
Already said me. All right, thanks, folks. In Search of the Amherst County Wildman.
Act one, scene one. On a screen above the stage, we see eerie footage of woods and fog. On stage, a hiker runs from the back of the theater, looking behind in terror. Once on stage, she backs across the stage until the beast leaps out at her, roaring. The beast is obviously a man in a poorly made suit. They freeze. In a suit with hair saturated in product, James Cushing enters.
Every year, hundreds of people go missing in the backwoods of America. How many have fallen victim to the terrifying wild man of Amherst County? Good evening. I'm James Cushing, and this is Creature Quest.
The sound mixer's bell rings. The hiker sits down, and the beast removes his mask.
Great job, guys. Especially you, John. Really felt the primal rage.
The beast shakes his head, walks off stage, flipping Cushing off.
Well, I'm serious. You're really making that BFA work for you. Jesus, how many episodes of this? 20? We ran out of good monsters 3 seasons ago. And I swear to God, Johnson, if I have to look at one more dead coyote that someone thinks is a chupacabra, I will murder you! In another universe, I'm probably giving my Oscar acceptance speech. But there's probably another one where I'm trading head for crack, so I guess I should count my blessings. All right, on to Virginia.
Scene two.
Mr. Earp? Yeah, he's been looking for Bigfoot since, God, probably the 60s.
God, it's embarrassing. We're just getting the meth overdoses under control, but we still have this guy making us look bad. Did you know it's been 3 months since the last meth lab explosion? Small miracles.
Who's Carl Earp?
Scene three. Cushing is checking his hair in a small mirror. Carl, see Earp, is standing next to him.
Is it always this humid?
It's summer.
Ugh. We should move this freak show inside, huh? Nervous?
Well, actually.
Relax. We'll do fine. You're working with a professional.
Thanks. Just worried I'll say or do something stupid.
Like spending 40 years looking for Bigfoot?
What?
And we're back. James Cushing here, and we're talking with professional... Professional? Really?
Well, sort of.
We'll go again. James Cushing here, and we're talking with professional monster hunter Carl Earp. He spent nearly 40 years combing the backwoods of... 40 years? Really? By your 10, you were seriously rethinking your life decisions?
Hey!
I mean, come on. After 20 years of daytime TV and commercials for ITT Tech, you never thought, hey, I ought to give them a call.
You're just going to make fun of me.
Relax. I'm kidding. Hey, I've been doing this gig for 3 years, and I feel like eating a snub-nosed 38 every morning. What? I'm not badgering the guests. I'm not badgering. Am I badgering?
Well,
see, Earp here says that I'm not badgering. Tell you what. You tell your story, and we'll edit it later, okay?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, you know the drill. I mean, you've been on a million of these shows, right?
Well, 15.
My God.
I got to meet Robert Stepp.
Terrific. Let's do this.
My name is Carl C. Earp. No relation. Apparently, someone somewhere thought, why not? Alcoholism runs in my family. I expect it had a lot to do with it. I've been looking for Bigfoot since, God, 1958. I was 10 years old when I saw it.
Now, here's where we'll insert a nice reenactment.
It was huge. I mean, I've never seen anything like it before. It was massive. And God, it stunk. Some people say I've wasted my life, but they haven't seen it for themselves. Thrill. My dad, before he left my mom and me, now he'd tell me stories going way, way back before there was even a town here. People saw it then. That's how we bonded, you know?
Now, this is your last outing, correct?
Yeah, they've been trying to make this reservoir for as long as I've been here. And now, people are clearing off the land and creeks are already rising. Between that and being old as hell, I'm running out of time.
How old are you?
64 this May.
That is old. I'm 42, so I have quite a few years left to accomplish things. Go on.
Well, you know, I'm going out on a practice run, getting an idea of what I'll need, and then I'm going out for the last time. Staying out there as long as it takes. I mean, sure, I'd like to prove it exists. I mean, if I had, they wouldn't be flooding the bottoms. Also, kids might not be trash-talking or leaving as many bags of flaming dog excrement on my porch. I mean, that does get old.
And we're good. Thanks. Let's pack it up. Can I have someone get me a Sierra Mist? Thank you.
Well, that's it?
Yes. Did you want some more FaceTime or something?
I mean, you know, if that's all the footage you're going to get.
Of course we'll throw in some reenactments and get some shots of the woods before we call it good. Our guy in the suit is excellent. Went to NYU, did you know that?
I did.
Yeah, you think you have regrets? Jesus. Any day now with that Sierra Mist.
Yeah, I was kind of thinking you won't see me prepare and all.
Why?
I mean, this is my last search.
And?
I mean, that's a huge deal for me. This is my life's work.
You want this preserved for history or something?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. I mean, you think it's dumb and I get it, but this is all I have. I'm gonna leave something behind.
Look, don't take this the wrong way, Mr. Earp.
Usually when people say that, there's no other way to take it.
No one put a gun to your head and said, waste your life chasing excrement that doesn't matter.
Yeah, nobody put a gun to yours neither.
Touché. But we don't have the time. Where in the name of Jesus, Mary, and L. Ron Hubbard is my Sierra Mist?
Terrified crew member brings Cushing a glass and runs off stage.
Thank you. They're like animals. You have to break them.
Yeah, it won't take much of your time.
We have to be in Florida hunting this giant squid by next Thursday.
What if it wasn't for Creature Quest?
Go on.
It could be a documentary.
On you?
No. Well, yes. I mean, look at it this way. Now, I'm a crazy person. Everybody says I'm a crazy person. You think I'm a crazy person. That could be your angle.
Interesting.
You could show this at festivals.
Oh, it'd be like that Anvil documentary.
Sure. What was that?
Oh, these guys did a whole documentary on a band that was a complete failure.
Oh.
I mean, they kept trying long after they should have quit.
That sounds familiar.
I mean, it was huge. And this will be just like it.
Yeah. Just like it. Oh, you'll do it?
Yeah, I'll talk to the crew. The last days of Carl Earp.
Now, that's a little dark.
Obsession, the tragic last years of Carl Earp.
How about a title that lets me hold on just a sliver of my dignity?
Tough one.
Yeah, it kind of is, right?
Yeah, I'm thinking. Wait, no.
Kind of disheartening how difficult this is.
Got it. In search of the Amherst County Wildman.
I like it.
You do?
Yeah.
Well then, Mr. Earp, let's do this.
Scene 4. Cushing, cameraman, and Earp are entering. They stop at Earp's crumbling mobile home.
So it wouldn't be an exaggeration to say this sighting changed your life.
Oh, no way. It was life-changing. I mean, you can't have an experience like that and it not change it, you know? I mean, I saw something. Bigfoot or whatever you want to... Well, here it is. Home sweet home. It's a bit rustic.
Rustic? I'd say your door is nearly 70% duct tape.
Oh, I've seen better days.
Is the roof supposed to sink in like that?
I'm not exactly a handyman or anything.
Do you even have insulation or do the rats living in your wall suffice?
Hey, maybe I'll discover some lost Spanish gold while I'm out there.
Well, that would pay for the gas to burn this eyesore to the ground.
Well, now you're being dramatic.
There are homeless people living in boxes sturdier than this place.
You done, Mr. Cushing?
It's leaning.
Ever lived in a mobile home before?
No, but I've also never stepped in front of a moving truck or drank lighter fluid.
Another one of these.
Herb picks up an envelope from the ground. On it, in large letters, is written, Bigfoot proof, photos.
Bigfoot photos, huh? People send you stuff like this often?
Well, one person.
A light comes up on Roman.
Hell yeah, send those pictures.
And they're not Bigfoot pictures.
They're pictures of my dick. If he's lucky. Sometimes I just find really weird stuff off the net. Some of it's probably illegal.
Yeah, Roman's pretty much my best friend.
So you guys filming a documentary on his last search? All these shows like on History and Discovery are coming down here. They act like they're all interested, but they end up making Carl look like an idiot.
Yeah, he watches out for me.
And sends you dick pics.
Well, he's a nice guy, I'll give you that.
Yeah, I started sending them just to screw with him. He caught me dropping one off one day. We started talking, realized we had a lot in common, knew the same people.
He's a good guy. Yeah,
I thought being friends, he'd stop sending these, but now I'm getting them twice a week.
Do I believe him? Yeah, I believe him. He saw something. Why else would he be out there doing this? He even said he shot it once, but it got away. He was so close. He got so excited and then come home to find his dad ran out on him. That's Herb's luck. Look, he's not making money. Everyone thinks he's baddie. I got a maintenance gig at Sweetbriar College. I got retirement. I got bonuses. What's Carl got? He makes scratch picking up trash on the square 4 days a week. Oh, don't call him a trash man. He's real sensitive about that.
I'm not a trash man. Now, pick up trash, that made me a trash man, does it? I mean, yeah, Roman's an odd guy, you know, mainly from the accident. There's a scar in the back of his head. It's all messed up. You know, when he was like 20, he was driving with his girl, old country road, kind of drizzly, when a car slams into him, kills her. He spends all this time recovering. His head's all screwed up.
Herb told you about that, huh? Yeah, well, I couldn't control emotions for a long time. Weird stuff. Stabbed my brother with a Phillips head screwdriver. We're arguing who was a better frontman for Van Halen, Hagar or Roth. Apparently, I was a very passionate fan of Sammy Hagar. So there's that.
He's better. He's got an odd sense of humor. Tends to piss people off.
Carl gets me. People may laugh, but I don't know. He has plenty of reasons to hate my guts, but he does it. He's good people, as they say.
The lights go down on Roman. Earp is showing Cushing around his house. Cameraman is present.
Yeah, it's a mess.
It's a war zone.
Yeah, but I bet there's fewer stacks of TV guides in Iraq.
Most of these are from the mid-90s.
Well, you know, Mom always said no point in getting new ones. They always play the same thing over and over anyway. You know, she passed several years ago. I just never got around to picking a place up. Don't really spend too much time here, to be honest.
Sorry to hear that.
Yeah, cancer.
That's what got my mom, too. She was younger, though.
Well, we have something in common.
Cancer is something everyone has in common.
Well, near the end, she pretty much slept around the clock. You know, at least it seemed that way. Becky'd come by. That was our hospice nurse. She moved her, bathed her. Stuff I wasn't exactly keen on doing, but she was a firecracker. Said whatever was on her mind. Used to say, Carl, dadgummit, you're a trash man, not a monster hunter.
Ouch.
Yeah, I suspect, though, it came from a place of love. She loved as well as she could, but her childhood was hard on her. My dad running out didn't help, neither.
Something else we have in common.
Well, you know, I guess that's its own cancer. Well, it's a mess, but this is basically my command center. I got my poster from The Legend of Boggy Creek. Jet, my ex, she got that for me.
Jet?
It's a nickname. Her real name is Isis. Her parents were different.
No, they were cruel.
No. They were also addicted to PCP. Her old man was busted for trying to punch his way through a McDonald's window.
That is just one tractor reference away from being the ultimate redneck story.
Yeah. Fair enough. Anyway, watching your show, seeing the stuff you guys got, it kind of inspired me. Check it out.
Good to know we're making a difference.
Herb runs off stage briefly, returns dragging a plastic tub.
And what is this?
My gear. I got everything.
Let's see it.
Now, I worked pretty hard to acquire all this, but it's necessary if you want results, you know?
Cushing motions for the camera to move in while Earp shows off the contents of his tub and bag.
I got digital cameras, a couple of those camera traps.
All on a trash man's, a maintenance man's salary. We have some of the same camera traps, actually.
Yeah, I haven't had too much luck with them. I got a lot of pictures of deer and marmots. Once I thought I had a picture, but it was just me walking around the woods.
So you have as much luck with them as we do.
Yeah, a couple tape recorders. I got some infrared cameras on layaway at Hart & Sons Incorporated Pond.
So have you got anything at all from all this stuff?
Well, about as much as you guys. Blurry pictures. Nothing concrete, you know. I keep a lot of it in the Monstow Mobile.
I am almost scared to ask.
That's how I get around. I got a good deal on an old food truck and converted it to the ultimate Bigfootin'-mobile.
Jesus, is Bigfootin' an actual term now?
You want a documentary on my search or a documentary on a sarcastic a-hole who can't shut his damn mouth for 5 seconds?
Apologies. Go on.
So I converted the food truck, or roach coach as they're also known. It's killing you not to say anything, isn't it?
Yes. My God, yes.
Well, I have my recordings of Bigfoot yells I use for call blasting.
You have tapes of Bigfoot yells?
Well, so do you guys. You use them all the time on the show.
Yeah, but they're a combo of bear growls and yodels our sound guy came up with.
What?
Nothing. Let's hear your calls.
Earp pulls out a tape recorder, presses play. Static and howls are heard.
There's a ton of them on YouTube. Plus my night vision goggles, tons of videotape from a camera, plus the bed. It's honestly, I'd rather sleep there than here.
So a lot of memories in this house, huh?
Yeah, then again, small town is made of memories.
You grew up here and never left?
No, it's home.
I left home as soon as I could. I wasn't sticking around.
Oh, not many people do.
There's a reason.
There's a reason to stay, too, at least for me. My mission, my monster. It was just Mom and me for a long time. Dad left in 65. The place is paid for, so that's good. Tough to bring a girl home, when the whole town thinks you're a loon. There aren't too many opportunities for getting laid.
Well, you don't exactly have a wide selection.
No, not exactly.
So, how long are we talking?
How long?
Your dry spell. When's the last time you get laid?
The last time?
Lights up on a prostitute, barely dressed. Lay down. Arms at your side. You didn't bring a condom? Well, crap. You're clean, right? Fine. $20 unless you want the fancy stuff. Give me a heads up when.
Lights out on prostitute.
I don't recall, actually.
Okay. Happens to the best of us.
Yeah, I guess. Ooh, I got some footprints, too.
Oh.
See? One of these is fake, and the other is real. You know how you tell?
No.
The one on the right is fake. The toes aren't splayed, which is what happens to a real foot when stepping on the muddy creek bed and leaving tracks behind. Plus, there's no mid-tarsal break.
What?
Well, see, real prints have a break in the middle where the mid-tarsal joint is. Well, this means they're flat-footed. And their transverse tarsal joint has way bigger range of motion than a human's ever could. We have one, but theirs is very different. Definitely not human. Plus, the one on the left has dermal ridges. Those lines that make up your fingerprints, we have them on our feet and toes, too. They're impossible to fake.
Did you get the real one from here?
Mail order.
Ah.
But I'm still looking. I've been reading a lot about primate locomotion, so I can recognize the real thing.
And I'm not trying to be a smartass here, but if you put this much effort and study into literally any other field, you probably wouldn't be living in a trailer.
You sound like my ex.
She might have had a point.
Well, guess we'll see when all this is said and done.
Sure. That's the point of the documentary.
Uh-huh. Well, you ready to go out there?
Out there?
to the bottoms, where I'm going to be searching. You can't go with me on the actual search. Large group of people will just scare it away.
Certainly.
So, we should go out there now.
How far out there?
Scene 5. Cushing, cameraman, and Earp are walking around as they explore the woods. Earp is carrying a rifle. Cushing is exhausted and struggling with his cumbersome walking stick. He sees a bug on it, throws the stick, wiping his hands on his leg.
How far have we walked?
I don't know, maybe half a mile.
You're kidding. I might die.
You're 10 years younger than me.
15.
That's worse.
Give me a break. I'm the host of a basic cable schlock fest, not a mountain man.
Hey, what happened to the walking stick I gave you?
Had a bug on it.
So, just brush it off. That was a perfectly good walking stick.
What if there were more? Hiding. They watched me kill their friend and suddenly they're thirsty for revenge.
Well, that's a completely logical thought process, Mr. Cushing.
Touché.
Yeah. Well, it's usually quieter out here. Damn cicadas.
How do you move through this stuff?
Yeah, undergrowth is getting pretty thick down here. Closer we get to the steel parts of the creek, the worse the mosquitoes will get too, so heads up.
Lovely.
Did you spray yourself?
Yeah, picked up the stuff for sensitive skin. Smells like summer rain, according to the bottle.
Awesome. Better hope that stuff had deep. Ticks are thick out here.
Ticks?
Yeah, don't worry. I'll check you when we get back.
I need to check for ticks.
I'll be honest. It's going to get awkward.
So the forests of Virginia are a tick and mosquito-infested hellhole, crawling with monsters?
Sorta. But the trees. Look at them. So tall, so close together, they block out the sun. The ground is nothing but leaves and twigs. Years, decades. Layer after layer. Everything out here is older than your parents' parents. Anything could live out here.
Even a monster?
Bingo. In the 1800s, people would talk about the wild man that lived in the woods. Indians said it was a lost tribe. More animal than man. Old stuff. Ancient stuff.
Crazy stuff?
That's such a sad way to see the world.
So, tromping through the woods, sweating my ass off is enlightenment?
Could be. Works for me.
So, your dad, he believed all this stuff too?
Yeah. He told me stories about him when I was little. When I saw the monster, he wasn't surprised. He always said if more people saw it, they wouldn't build the reservoir.
Well, it took a long time. They're just now doing it.
And I suppose.
And they're flooding all of this?
Yep. Be one giant lake. Hey, watch for copperheads.
What are those?
Snakes! Really, really poisonous snakes.
Of course they are.
Yeah, I thought you'd be used to all this kind of stuff with what you do on Creature Quest.
Work? We usually set up in a park. Throw on some night vision filters, film our guy in a suit, or have some intern hitting trees with sticks for wood knocking.
You fake that stuff?
Seriously? Yes! You don't think those close encounters are real, do you? Every show like ours is fake.
Well, this is real.
I know. That's why we haven't found anything.
Well, just watch the ground.
Are you allowed to bring a gun out here?
Yeah. Anyone can bring a gun out here. Although, technically, I'm not. There was an incident.
He shot me. Yeah, like, in murder. My friend and I thought it would be funny to dress up as Bigfoot. You know, mess with Mr. Earp a little bit. Got shot in the leg. Hurt. Bad.
Jesus, man!
Nah, it was blown out of proportion. I nicked him. But he started it. Running around the woods like that, what do you think would happen?
Well, apparently not that he'd get nicked by a trigger-happy monster hunter.
But I did get a shot at it. The real thing. It was the fourth time I saw it. And I got a shot in. It fell and ran away.
How old were you?
Just a kid, around 12.
Did you kill it?
Never found the body. I was so close to proving it. I could have saved our land, made us rich, proved I wasn't crazy. Instead, Dad left, Mom drank, and I stayed in the woods.
Have you seen it again?
I saw it again in 1993.
So you're okay killing it?
Yep.
What if it's the last of its kind, or has a baby or something?
Well, how else am I going to prove it? I mean, I'm not going to my grave with everyone thinking I've lost my mind. I mean, all I have is blurry pictures and a plastic tub full of footprint casts.
What? What if nothing is out here? Carl?
Well, what did I see?
A bear? Who knows? You said yourself you were just a kid.
It's too late to stop now.
Well, that's not true.
It is. I spent too long in the woods. Lost too many years in the trees and creeks.
I understand. Just calm down.
There's no stopping.
Okay, calm down.
Afraid I'll shoot you?
Is there an answer that guarantees you won't shoot me?
Scene 6. Cushing stands in front of Earp's house. Earp walks up with a bottle in hand.
Where did you go?
Oh, just running a little errand. Really is a dump.
You could definitely do better.
Well, I was just thinking that.
Earp brings a beer bottle with a rag sticking out of it.
You guys ever hear of a Molotov cocktail?
When did you make that?
When you and your cameraman snuck out in the brush smoke a joint.
I have a prescription.
I ain't no judgment here.
Earp fishes a lighter from his pocket.
Wait, what are you?
Earp lights it.
Stop!
Earp throws it off stage. Explosion and fire.
Jesus, what's wrong with you?
Oh, don't worry. There's plenty of nicer boxes there I can sleep in.
We should call the police, the fire department.
It'll be all burned out by the time they get here. Why are you worried? It was your idea.
It's literally a shack, but I didn't mean to burn it down.
You suggested it.
Please do not tell the police that. What's wrong with you?
I told you. This is it. My last time out. No going back.
Scene 7. Earp is on the phone. A light comes up on Jet, wearing a uniform shirt from Sheets.
Hey, Jet. Just get off?
Yeah, but I have to be in early. What do you need?
Is he...
No, Carl. He's not here. Just me.
Well, then.
Carl, please. I don't have time for this.
Come on, Jet. I was just playing.
What do you want?
I'm gonna be on TV.
You've already been on TV.
No, this is about me, not Bigfoot.
Oh, really?
Yep. Just me and my search.
Oh, good. Good for you, I guess.
So, maybe not everyone thinks it's so stupid.
I never said it was stupid. I was with you for almost 25 years.
You gave up, though.
Yes. When it became pretty damn obvious, there wasn't anything out there.
Jet.
Carl, you saw the wooden feet.
That wasn't what I saw.
You saw them.
No. That wasn't what I saw when I was a kid. It wasn't what I saw in 93. It couldn't have really been him, then, could it?
In all that time, you only saw it once after he left your mom and you. What does that tell you?
Nothing.
You're lying to yourself.
You never believed me, not really.
I did, Carl. Honestly, I did.
What I saw wasn't human. It wasn't a guy in a suit.
Aren't you tired of it?
Of looking? Yeah, I get tired.
No, of being everyone's damn punchline. Kids coming by to meet you and trying not to laugh when you tell them about what you saw.
Is that why you left? Because I was a joke to you?
Yes.
Ouch.
Sorry.
I mean, damn. I guess I didn't expect you to be so honest.
Well, there it is. Maybe you could deal with the smiles and giggles, but I sure as hell couldn't. Besides, I gave you a choice.
What choice?
Your monster or me.
If you wanted to stay with me, you wouldn't give me a choice.
Maybe you're right. Maybe I just needed an excuse.
If I stopped tomorrow, would it help?
You couldn't stop.
I could try.
I'm married, and you can't stop.
You're right. I've been at it too long. I will find it, damn it.
Then what?
What?
Okay, you find it. Then what are you gonna do, Carl? Carl?
The lights go down on Earp, who exits. Who sits looking at his phone. They stay up on Jet.
No, I'm not surprised he hasn't given up. He won't. He'll die out there in those bottoms. I don't know, it was a lot of things. What's the word? Resentment. A lot of resentment. I mean, of course there's always that one thing, that there's always a straw. You'll have to ask him. You'll have to ask him. Ask him about the letter. If he wants to say something, he will. Or ask him about the feet. All I'm gonna say is the last time he saw the monster was right before his daddy left him. Yeah. Right after that time, he said he shot at it or whatever. I don't know. He just came home and he was gone. Look, my husband's about to come home. Yes, my husband and Carl know each other. It can be awkward.
You still talking to these guys?
What's up?
You want to catch Carl? I think he's going down to the bottom tonight. Hey, honey.
Is there anything else?
Scene 8. Cushing is on the phone, pacing.
I know we were supposed to be in Florida, but you got to trust me. I've got something better. But this is good stuff. What? Replace me? You're firing me? Who's going to take my place, huh? John? The ass hat and the monkey suit? No. This is better than Squidge. This is real. We're talking cover-ups. Trust me, when you see... Look, there are some major things that have happened here, and I don't think anybody really understands what's going on. We're talking murder, monsters, everything. Fine. And come get your stuff yourself. I have a show to film.
Cushing hangs up the phone.
Unbelievable!
Cushing throws it across the stage.
My phone!
Scene 9.
Real shame guy's back on and off the way he did. Never took him for the kind who would leave a kid behind. No wonder her was so screwed up. Nobody was around to knock some sense into him.
Yeah, I heard her. Everybody did that there. Well, you know, I think he knew the person. I think the whole thing was
Damn, Shane. Damn, Shane.
Scene 10. Cushing and Earp are sitting down in front of Earp's smoldering home, trading drinks from a bottle.
Wow. Place burned up quick.
Yeah, it did.
Well, still got about half a house.
I'd say a third.
Really enjoying our little tea party here. Whiskey?
Hand it over. That's good stuff. I never figured you'd pour a whiskey drinker.
I blame Westerns. I loved them when I was a kid. You see these guys covered in dust, sweat, saunter up to a rotted wood bar, get a drink. They pause. Look it over, down the hatch.
You like Westerns?
Every man likes Westerns, whether they admit it or not. I see a man with a purpose, a code, even villains have something they're fighting for. No offices, cubicles, just vast, empty spaces.
Never cared for Westerns much.
What do you like?
Monster movies.
Makes sense to me.
Yeah. So, what are you going to do now?
Finish your documentary.
Really?
Yeah, it's your legacy. Probably mine, too.
Thanks. You won't have much more to do.
What?
I don't think I can stand up.
Lightweight. Then again, I drink to drown sorrows, and working at Creature Quest has given me plenty of sorrows to drown.
Oh, God, come on. I mean, there are worse jobs out there. You weren't digging ditches.
So at least I can say it was better than digging ditches. Maybe in another universe, there is a me digging dishes. A me that would have killed to host that stupid show.
What are you talking about?
Oh, no, we had this guy on the show talking about multiple universes. That every time you make a decision, no matter how small, it creates an entire universe. You decide to drink a Dr. Pepper instead of a Pepsi. There's two universes you created right there.
That sounds like a load of bull to me.
Coming from a professional Bigfoot hunter.
Touche.
So, I always imagine these universes where I'm rich, famous, or destitute and forgotten. I wonder which ones are the better ones. Which ones I'm the happiest in. Or am I the same in them all?
You know, you sound like the kind of guy who could be sharing a bed with 20 supermodels on a mansion on a hill and still find crap to complain about.
Probably right.
Damn straight.
We talked to Jet. She mentioned some footprints.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Also something about a letter. She wouldn't say anymore.
That's nothing. Forget it.
Well, do you want...
I don't want to talk about it.
You wanted a documentary, so I'm documenting. The good with the bad.
I'm a joke to you. I know that. I also know I'm the only chance that I have to leave something behind, a record, a legacy. I mean, even if it's this.
I don't think you're a joke.
Bull.
Okay, I did.
Yeah?
I thought you were an uneducated backwards hick.
Oh, what do you think now?
You're still an uneducated backwards hick. But you're like me. You want to do something different, make your mark on the world. Why are you still chasing this thing?
To prove it exists!
No. Because you're destined, you think you're destined to prove it exists. You're destined to do something great. Everyone thinks they're destined for greatness, but few try, and even fewer succeed.
Did you?
My big boast was hosting Creature Quest. What do you think? I wanted to do Shakespeare on Broadway. I wanted to do edgy plays about drugs and sex off Broadway. I wanted to star in movies knowing all those little bastards that pushed me around in high school would be sitting in the audience watching me be great.
You wanted a lot of things.
It's not over yet. For me or you.
You say we quit?
No. I'm saying we do this. I'll go with you. Screw it. I'll leave the cameras behind.
And do something great?
Yes!
Tempting. Very tempting. But I still think we should finish the documentary first.
Oh, no. Can't do that. Because you're holding out on me.
What?
Jet hinted at some pretty provocative stuff. Fake feet and lost letters. And my star. My star is holding out on me?
A star, huh?
Of this little film? Definitely. Come on. Just tell me.
Fine. But I don't want you to put it in the documentary.
We'll play it by ear. Let's hear it.
The feet? I found them when my mom died. She hid them from me. I was going through her stuff, seeing what to keep and what to trash, and found them.
What were they?
Wooden cutouts of giant human footprints nailed to the bottom of a couple old work boots.
Whoa. That had to be...
disheartening, to say the least.
And there was a note?
Yeah, the note. She wrote it years before, telling me that it wasn't real. Dad faked it.
There's no monster?
I didn't say that. No, I said Dad faked some of it.
Come on.
No, don't look at me like that.
So she let you keep running around hunting monsters?
Look, in this note, dated January the 7th, 1988, she told me how they first wanted to build this reservoir back in the 50s. And that's about the same time they found those footprints up in California and coined the phrase Bigfoot. So my dad, he got this idea.
Which was?
Well, convince people that there was a monster in the woods. It might delay the reservoir. You know, have scientists and stuff looking around. People could keep their land. Nobody gets hurt.
It's pretty clever.
Yeah, but then I saw him. He thought it was funny. So, you know, he kept going out there so I could see the monster.
It was him the whole time?
No. You see, there was a monster. A real one. That's what I saw. That's what I shot. That day I hit it, I ran home to tell Dad, but he'd already left.
Yeah, Jet mentioned that. Your dad disappeared the same day you shot the monster.
He left. He didn't disappear.
He just drove away?
Well, he left his truck. But yeah, he was gone. Left my mom and me. I came home, told her I shot the monster. She started crying. I guess she already found out he left.
Did he leave a note, or did she report him missing?
Why are you asking?
No idea where he went.
Never knew. Mom and him never exactly got along.
So, he was willing to dress up like a monster to make you feel good about yourself. That's not the kind of dad that runs out. My dad drank Mad Dog 2020 like it was on tap and then took turns wailing on me and my brother. That's the kind of dad that walks out.
Well, when I got home, Dad was gone. Mom was tore up pretty bad. Wouldn't even look at me for the longest.
Without his truck? Did he hitchhike?
I don't know, Cushing.
And the first thing you told your mom was that you shot him.
Yeah.
You ever think that might be the reason she never gave you that letter?
What are you talking about?
Carl, don't take this the wrong way. I think you killed your dad.
Blackout. Act 2, Scene 1. Lights up on Jet.
Why'd you have to say that? We don't know that for sure. Well, have you talked to him at all? Yeah, no one has. I keep telling Roman to get over there and check on him.
He don't need me checking on him.
You're his friend.
He's a grown man. He don't want to talk. Don't do that. Stop it. Come on, man. Fine. I'm going.
See that? That's how I got a new car and tickets to Travis' trip without saying one word. Also, I don't have to do that one thing Roman used to bug me for all the time. I'm married. I paid my dues.
Scene two. In a stage shirt and boxers, Earp is sitting on the ground. Roman enters, putting his wallet in his back pocket.
You could have knocked.
I did. You didn't answer.
You could have taken the hint.
Yeah, but instead I picked your lock with my driver's license. There you go.
You picked a lock? The entire half of the house is burned down.
Yeah, but I would have got ash all over the floor. Seemed rude, you know.
What are you doing here?
Checking on you.
Jen send you?
Yeah.
She do that staring thing?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I hate her.
Sucks. So,
Didn't shoot my dad, Roman.
So this wallowing in self-pity thing is completely unrelated then.
Shouldn't you be nailing my ex-wife?
Oh, there's time for that, for sure. Right now, I just want to know how you're doing. For real, not to get all mushy and all, but you can't talk to me.
I guess I never thought those two things were related. You know, I mean, two separate events. I never put them together.
You were a kid.
I was 12.
A kid?
I was old enough to know better.
You weren't the one dressing up like a monster to scare people. So I guess that's it, huh?
But what?
Your whole Bigfoot hunt, your movie. No point now, is there?
I'm not quitting.
What? Wait, why not?
I'm still going out there.
Well, what's the point?
You sound like Jet.
Because you know there's nothing out there.
No. There's a monster out there, Roman.
Buddy, come on.
My dad might have been dressing up like one, but he wasn't the only thing out there. There were sightings long before he was even born.
Yeah, sightings he told you about.
You want me to quit?
Yeah.
Jet wanted me to quit.
Still does.
40 years just to quit.
Look, no one thinks any less of you for being tricked.
I'm not stopping.
Carl.
I'm not stopping.
You're a grown man. You do what you think is right.
Thank you.
Still here, you know. For you.
Stop that crap.
All right, jackass. See you later.
Yeah, later, butthead.
Scene three.
Yeah, we heard. Well, people have been saying as much for years now. Carl's old man was an odd duck. Him out there trying to be some monster. The boy looking for one? Something was bound to happen. No, not about having an investigation or anything. Well, would it help? Nobody. No sign of any foul play. Didn't do anyone any good. Besides, who would we arrest? No. That sad bastard's had enough go wrong with his life, and I'm not about to pile on anymore.
When I was a kid, my buddies and I were piling down the woods for rocks and stuff, and then we seen on History Channel thing talking about how the monster is territorial, will throw rocks when people get too close. That stuff was fun.
Scene 4. Cushing, Earp, and Camera Guy are walking deep in the woods.
We don't have to finish the film.
What about your big comeback?
Don't worry about me. I've got a few projects on hold.
No, you don't.
Fine. I don't. But considering everything that's happened, I've thought about it, and we don't have to do this.
No. You put too much time in.
Are you okay? I keep asking,
No funny comments, no rolling your eyes at me.
There's nothing to laugh at, Carl. This is serious.
Falling behind. Catch up.
Look. Maybe that's not what happened. Maybe your dad just ran off.
Yeah. If I'm lucky, maybe my dad just didn't love me.
Guess there's no win in this scenario, is there?
Explains why my mom hid the note. Hunting monsters is better than prison, I suppose.
What I don't understand is why you're still out here. I mean, you saw the wooden feet. Your dad disappears the same day you shoot the monster. What are you looking for?
Maybe Dad pretended to be the monster once or twice, but he wasn't there that day. I mean, there's something out here, and I intend to find it.
Let's stop and think for a moment.
No going back, remember?
Carl!
Look, I know what I know what you're doing.
What are you talking about?
Oh, you're the one who told me about my dad. Now you're acting all sad like you want to help.
I do!
You don't want to stop the film? Not really. You're just saying so to convince me that you're looking out for me.
Carl, listen to me. You're my friend. I'm not trying
to... I know what you're doing. You got canned. Now you want to make sure this little movie is nice and juicy.
What are you talking about?
That you just happened to put together the clues. No one else knew.
Everyone else knew. Your mom knew. Those Barney Fife wannabes downtown knew. And you know it.
Erp pushes Cushing.
Okay. Carl.
Erp pushes Cushing again.
What's that?
Seriously, stop it.
Erp keeps pushing.
Seriously? Stop it? Seriously? You seriously want me to stop it?
Look, I'm warning you.
Oh, you better walk away.
I'm not looking for a fight, Erp, but this is ridiculous.
Erp nudges him.
Okay!
I bet you used to get pushed around like this all the time.
Stop it!
What are you gonna do?
Carl?
Erp gets in Cushing's face, giving him one defiant push.
Okay, that's it.
Erp stumbles backwards, giving his biggest come-at-me-bro expression.
Bring it on, Winnie boy!
Don't write checks your Social Security can't cash, Grandpa!
Erp yells and tackles Cushing. They grapple at each other until Cushing awkwardly crawls away.
That was the single saddest fight I've ever been in.
Erp remains on the ground.
Oh, God. Are you crying?
I'm not crying because of you.
Oh.
You hit like a little girl.
I was holding back, you bastard.
I'm crying because you're right. Okay?
About the film?
About my dad. It was him. It had to be.
Sorry. Look, I'll admit, at first I thought it was something that could really push the documentary over the top. But after I got to know you, I haven't filmed anything about your dad. Not one second.
Really?
Yeah. And I'm surprised, too, actually. And I won't.
Well, I appreciate that.
Unless you want me to.
Would be a nice twist, wouldn't it?
Nothing earth-shattering for the audience. I didn't mean you, but it could definitely help keep the audience invested.
Well, I'll think about it.
Sure.
But I saw the monster in 1993. At least I thought so. I mean, it was dark out.
Why do you keep looking? Carl, we don't have to put this in or anything else.
Because a deadbeat dad is better than a dead one. If I find that monster, then I didn't kill my dad. And if I find my dad, well, then I guess I'll have closure in a nice cell somewhere.
This really is your last chance.
Once they flood the bottoms, anything that was out there is lost forever. I have to know. What did I see?
Jesus, look at this place.
Erp stands up.
Yeah. People that own land are clearing it off, selling the trees for lumber.
Wow. It's like...
A bomb went off.
Yeah.
Might as well. I seen man-made lakes and reservoirs where the trees were left. They all die, tops sticking out of the water like a bunch of skeletons trying to stay above the waves. Sad thing to see.
Do they just die and fall down?
No, they stand there, jutting out of the water like they haven't given up being what they were before. Long after me and you were gone.
This is awful. Seriously.
What are you gonna do? People need water. People need land. I'm just glad I had it as long as I did.
You grew up here.
Yep.
It's all coming down.
I won't be my home anymore. Hell, the trailer will be underwater too.
Why are you still there? Didn't the government pay everyone?
Yeah, but I guarantee most of them out there stay. I mean, home isn't just a building, you know.
Where are you going?
I'm not worried.
He should be. He'll be homeless.
Maybe I'll pass with you.
Yeah, that'd be,
Well, maybe I'll find it.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll find it and make millions. People make millions for less, right?
Much less.
I'll buy a mansion. I'll buy both ones.
Cushing walks up to camera guy.
Go back to the van. Go. Would you consider me a friend?
Yeah.
Okay. As a friend, if I ask you something, will you be honest with me?
I guess.
This isn't a suicide mission, is it?
That's not why we're doing this. Come on. Get the tragic guy.
Not funny.
Probably get all the words. I'm not gonna show myself.
Swear?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, my word, everybody. Oh, come on, I'm done with that. I'm a one-on-one with that best friend. I'm still standing.
Did she leave you for Roman?
I found him, speaking. After mom died.
Ouch. Hey, my third ex-wife, my creature quest co-host. Yep. He's hosting the Olympics now. I'm in the hole for a collection agency for a Maserati that she decided she didn't need to pay for anymore.
Sorry, man.
Yeah.
Well, Jet thought it was over, and that's what I love. I couldn't stop. So she found someone else.
Lights go down on pushing and looking. Scene 5.
I saw Jet at the sheets every morning before work. It just happened. She wasn't happy, He told me he wasn't happy. I told Carl myself, but we didn't sleep right. He was upset. Hell, here's me. Buddy, you got over it.
I do love Carl. In a different way. I don't know. The way you love a kid. Like, I feel like Roman and I look after him. We check in on him, listen to his stories. I mean, I'm supposed to throw out the pizzas after work, but I save them and give them to Carl so he can bait the stupid thing with him. You believe that? He baits the monster with cold pizza. Or maybe he eats them himself and just has too much point to say anything. Can I tell you about his dad? Yeah. See now? Blind obsession. Sounds cruel, but I couldn't. Not anymore.
Yeah, I've heard about that.
Going out in the woods, staying out there as long as it takes. His obsession's taken everything else from him. The only thing left is his life.
God knows we got enough homes empty, too. Cheap. Right nice, if you ask me.
Scene 7. I mean, I'm supposed to throw up.
Lights up on Carl. He's wearing a camo jacket and carrying a stuffed backpack.
Here we go. Fingers crossed, gentlemen. It's the trial run for the real thing. See how long I can make it out there. I think this time I set some food by some camera traps. Pancakes. I hear they love pancakes with lots of syrup. Hopefully we got some. Otherwise, I'm back out here for as long as it takes. Okay, this is as far as you guys go. Don't want you spooking the beast.
Scene 8.
3 days. He falls, breaks his ankle, and is out there for 3 days. I don't know how he did it. Doctor says it's fine now. Some kids found him. All he says to me when I get there, "Did you check my camera traps?" I told him not to go out there. I told him I don't think he's affected. And I don't. No, he believed in something and never backed down. He never gave up. Can you guys say that? Can you say that you believed in something so much you're willing to sacrifice everything? I know I'm a crappy friend. He enjoyed me luck. Yeah.
Lights up on Irk in a wheelchair and gown.
Doctors say I'll be over this soon. Pneumonia, exposure. I figured I'd die out there. How can I stop? No one remembers the guy who quit trying. They only remember the guy who did it. I haven't done it. I haven't. I gave him my life. Jack, my jobs, hell, my reputation. My mom, God, she didn't need all that. Not with Dad gone. Is that all? You guys need anything else?
Lights down on Earth.
I mean, it won't stop. He'll go back out there and he'll die out there. Wait.
He's right. He's determined. He won't stop until the bottom's underwater or he dies out there. I mean, he stopped then.
Lights out. Scene 9. Irk is no longer wheelchair bound. He's carrying a box. Jet approaches.
Carl?
Irk drops the box.
Jet, who are you?
Good. Roman said you'd burned your house down.
Well, not all of it. I still got a third that's habitable.
That's good.
Here to wish me luck?
You can't go out there. You nearly died.
Oh, it was an accident.
Carl, you're old. We all are.
Well, not in spirit, baby.
Jesus, Carl.
My fire's still going strong.
Shut up!
I'm glad you came to see me. Now, we don't see you much outside of work, you know.
I know.
I appreciate it.
No problem. We love you, you know.
Stop that.
What?
You don't love me.
I do.
No, you pity me.
Yeah?
Well, I don't want that.
We're still friends, Carl.
I don't want to be your friend.
Well, then what do you want, Carl? Jesus.
Well, you love me like you did. I mean, I want you to look at me like you did.
Well, what about Roman?
Screw him. I mean, I love the guy, but you. I want you back. I want what we had.
We can't, Carl.
Just listen.
I'm sorry, we can't. And it won't do no good talking like that either.
I mean, even if I threw out my cameras and pushed the monster mobile into the lake, even if they unmash my tapes and plaster cast, I mean, everyone wants me to quit.
Then do it.
I will. This
one time. I will, right now, if we can go back.
No.
Please, I'm serious. I'll quit. Complete cold turkey. Right here, right now. Come on. What do you say? Jack, what do you say? Excuse me, I need to get ready. What was that?
I do love you, Herb.
You do?
Maybe not in the way you want, but I do.
Scene 10. Herb is packing a bag and getting dressed. Cushing is standing beside him.
Ankle's almost healed up. Well, Jed and Roman have already tried to talk me out of it. I'm going.
I'm not trying to talk you out of it.
That was a stupid accident. Won't happen this time.
I have another offer for you. Before you say no, hear me out.
Go on.
Cushing pulls a large wooden human footprint from his coat.
We fake it.
No.
No, wait, now, just listen.
I'm not a frog.
We have a suit. We have cameras. The trick is to make the footage just detailed enough to be intriguing, but just shaky enough to be inconclusive.
Won't really prove anything, will it?
Well, that's not the point.
What? That's exactly the point.
Look, this way, you save face. You bring back footage. People will believe you.
They'll all believe me.
Well, not everyone, of course, but definitely more.
No one will be suspicious that I got this footage after hanging around the Creature Quest guy.
Well, I'll come out and I'll say I never believed you.
You don't.
Well, that's not the point. I'll say the footage is compelling, that we need further expeditions. Think about it. What your dad tried to do, we'll do it. No more reservoir.
But we'll have to keep it up. Keep faking pictures and prints.
We won't.
Well, then how are we going to keep convincing people?
Look, people see what they want to see. You get a bunch of Bigfoot hunters out here, and I promise you, they'll start telling stories of howls and wood knocking, quick sightings, the whole nine yards. It'll be in their heads. But what do you care?
I know. Everyone that knows me, Roman and Jet, they know I sold out.
I promise they'll be happy for you.
Then what would I have? No, I'm going out.
We can do this.
I'm going.
Fine. Just give yourself another week. Deal? Just one more week.
I'm going out there.
Let me go too. Seriously, I've been camping. I even hiked a little once.
Sorry, James. This is just me.
I get it. I do. I get it. You need this. And I'm not saying don't go out there ever, just not right now.
Creeks are rising. The bottoms are being cleared out. You saw it.
I'll erase the tapes. That's right. No more documentary.
Please.
I'll do it. Then what?
Oh, you won't. You need him as much as I do.
Carl!
Look. Don't tell anyone. At least give me a head start.
You'll get a head start. That's all I'm promising.
That's good enough.
How long are you going?
As long as it takes. Days? Weeks? I don't care.
I can send my cameraman.
No! Like I said, don't want to risk scaring a monster. Hey, you know that stuff about alternate universes you were talking about?
Yeah.
I wonder if there's one where I don't sight it. I wonder what happened to that universe.
Nothing exciting.
Yeah, you're probably right.
If you're gonna go, you better go. Clock is running on your head start.
Thanks.
Just please don't die. I may have to dub some of your audio when we start editing, and then I'll be a pain in the ass if you're dead.
Yeah. Good one. Wish me luck.
Look.
Scene 11.
Maybe you really will find him. Back in the 70s, people were really interested in Bigfoot stuff. My uncle had a little stand, making good money selling souvenirs and shirts. Best of luck, Mr. Earp.
I give him a week. Find it? Nah, I told all the bastard dies out there. 1 week, 10 bucks. What do you say?
On the screen, there are shots of the woods, of police cars, and police officers walking through the woods with dogs.
It's
been 4 months. We know he's. Cops comb through those woods, walking in long lines, dogs and everything. Roman was out there for days looking for him.
No, I'm not okay. How stupid a question is that? No, he wasted his life. He saw something. No one dies just to mess with someone. Put that in your documentary. Let them know Carl Earp wasn't crazy. I like him. Hell.
She's looking around, walking off stage. Cushing walks on stage.
It's been 3 years. The body of Carl Earp was never found, and the bottoms are now a vast reservoir. Once the water rose, a couple of fishermen came upon a cave that was once high in the hills, now sitting at water level. Inside there was a skeleton, clad in a costume made from a ghillie suit and some scraps of a moth-eaten fur coat. He'd been there for decades. Using dental records, the body was positively identified as that of Franklin Bubba Earp, Carl Earp's father. They also found footprints where someone had recently visited the cave.
Beast walks on stage, following hiker's path.
In the end, I like to think that Mr. Earp found his monster. That he...
Cushing.
I'm James Cushing, and this has been Creature Quest.
The sound mixer's bell sounds. Beast pulls his mask off, wiping away the sweat. He smiles and pats Cushing on the shoulder as he walks off stage. Lights fade to black. End of show.
You cast.
Oops, I can't move this over here. That matches better.
All right. Are we? Is Elford online? Do we know? Can we tell?
No way of
knowing. All right.
Cool. Maybe.
Maybe.
He could text you.
Yeah, he could text me. If my butt buzzes, then yeah, we'll know.
Great.
Anyway.
Yeah, it's probably not done yet right. Online.
Probably not. So at this point, folks, what we'd like to do is just take a look at the questions that we passed out. And if you don't have a sheet here, I will reread them. Rather than collecting them and stuff, I thought maybe we'd just offer, you know, take your comments from right where you are. And we are recording this. And so any stuff we put down, Elford will hear. Again, this is just feedback towards putting this on a more fully realized production. So I'll just sort of read these off and we'll get your comments down. I'll try to repeat them. And Lauren, is it okay if, can you record these, or are you looking at something else, too?
I was looking at the Twitter to see if anyone's made those, but...
Yeah, okay, we can do that. Let me see.
I can also...
You gonna do both?
Michael probably could.
Yeah, that's right. Michael, you wanna write some stuff down?
Sure.
Okay.
I meant videotape.
You know, a pen?
I have a pen.
Okay, I've got one of those.
Oh, so you mean write
I'm just writing some of the stuff that's in the comments that we get back. We can collect. We can also collect people's stuff afterwards if you want to. But I'm just making sure we record some of these things for folks who don't have the sheets. Anyway, let's just open this up. So, first of all, let me just go to any general comments that people want to have this thing, either related to the questions or just feedback you have right off the top of your head about it that we can record. All right, any confusing parts? First question. Any characters' motivations unclear? Here's a better way of doing this. Tell you what, just read off what you got. If you wrote anything down, I'm not gonna go through the questions again, but what I put down here, one of the things I kind of noticed, and Cass, you also, as you've been doing this, please give your comments to this so we can record them, but one of the things I'd like to see more, I think, is to flesh out Roman and Jet's characters, especially their relationship to Carl. I don't think we get enough of that in this particular iteration of it. So maybe some scenes that sort of flesh out some of the background stuff, but especially building that relationship between both Roman and Carl and Jet and Carl. We get a good backstory for Roman that begins that, but that just made me curious. I wanted to see that stuff, especially more on the stage time. And also, I'd like maybe to see a little more in the play about the cost of losing the home. One of the things that struck me in listening to this today was that we hear a lot about, you know, the bottoms are going to be flooded. I'd like to see what the townspeople's reactions to that is, especially Carl's and Jets and Romans, and maybe that being another piece of the play, not just the story about hunting Bigfoot, but also what it's like to possibly lose this. So what's the cost and the advantages of continuing this thing for Carl? I think just need to see that more emphasized. So those are my shots about that.
Hey.
Yes?
I think the actors did very well in building the relationship, and I think that's something between Cushing and her also that a little bit more time. It kind of goes from this jerk to friends in a relatively short play, so you don't want to belabor it. I understand that. But I think a little bit more to just kind of understand Cushing, because there's some good things in there, but I think it'll...
Yeah, good. Okay, so between Cushing and Herb as well. Yeah, I agree. Yeah,
there was a specific bonding moment where you see him, you know...
Yeah. Not a specific bonding moment. Yeah, okay. Hang on here.
That's true.
He's there. Okay, yeah. Elford's here. And Katie, too. Katie Alley 7, okay. Yes, so, yeah, that's great. Thanks. Any others? Any other comments you got written down? Any confusions about the I mean, it's hard to kind of know this. We're just picking...
Sorry, we're like
interrupting. It's all
right. Yeah, that thing is like, it's Elford.
What's this?
Hey, Adrian.
Anyway.
Ed, one, just curiosity, the cutaways, was that a decision you made, or was that indicated in the script?
Some of the, good question, Joe, thanks. The question, were some of the cutaways what we made here, or is it indicated in the script? Both. Elford wrote it. Elford wrote it.
He done read it.
For there to be both video footage, you know, film footage, and stage action going on. So some of the decisions that I made about what was up on screen were mine just for this reading, and some of the continuity of it. The addition of the live camera feed was not necessarily something that was put in the script, but Elford leaves a lot of room for suggestion of making that work. He also, in the cast, we use different people for the, you know, other than the cast for townspeople, he double casts it or triple casts it, so but he's really kind of open to how that would work out. Not sure if it was done on stage, if I'd do exactly the same thing as I was watching it today, but I think I would want to use, you know, both things.
Yep.
Yeah, Jane.
I mean, because property values certainly went up for the people that are dead.
True. Question for Elford, if you can't hear it, is, was the reservoir an allusion to Smith Mountain Lake out there? Because certainly property values rose when they did that. I have no idea. Good question. Yeah, Joseph.
I don't know, isn't it a suggestion, but just kind of curiosity, did he ever consider putting any other people who were happy that the Bigfoot searches pushed off the contractors or at least someone else who was appreciative or kind of anti-reservoir movement? We only saw her for that.
Right. So the question, Elford, is, could there be some other people who are happy about contractors being pushed off the land, so happy about ERP possibly being successful? Yeah. Yeah.
Or at least the other people admit that they've come to terms
with it. Or people admit that they've come to terms with it, with the reservoir being...
Yeah, was happy to move, I suppose.
Yeah, would be happy to move, yeah. So both things, yeah. Okay.
Developing that reservoir, I hadn't thought about it until I started hearing y'all talk about it, but it gives it, it's a story of loss on two different levels.
Right.
The community loss and the personal loss.
Yeah, the reservoir aspect. Reservoir aspect being showing a loss on two different levels, yeah, and the community involvement with that. Thanks, yeah. Any others? Thank you very much, folks. If you would like to give us your forms, if you wrote anything down, please, you can leave with Lauren there and we'll record that. And thanks for coming out. Thank you, Aromas, for letting us do this. And everybody's patience. And... Oh, thank you. Okay, Mike's gonna pass out actually a flyer that has Panglossian's season, or the place that we're gonna be doing this season. So have at that. And we're trying to do, what I didn't say before, where Panglossian's trying to do something like this, a new reading, once a month.
We have a date.
And we do have a date?
The 6th.
Okay, April 6th at...
The Newtown Art Gallery.
Newtown Art Gallery in Williamsburg. So at the 6th, I guess we don't know the time yet. 6
p.m.
Okay, April 6th, 6 p.m., Newtown Art Gallery. And the play is
The King's Face.
So... come on out for that if you'd like, and thank you all very much for showing up.
Thank you.